Hello, I hope you enjoy our visibility presentation, and here we go.
One, two, three, four.
So tomorrow, Burma Shave type display is going up on 106 in Loudoun, and it's scheduled to rain. So one way to waterproof a sign is using packing tape and just go around and round and round. It's a bit time consuming, but it does seem to work. Okay, we're gonna set up the reader board, and we tried to make it as light as we could, and we tried to make it easy to set up. There's a couple of pegs. I'll get this side. Made this box for the letters, so you guys want to go ahead and start setting the sign up. So this is 1/4-inch Luan. We put a piece of softwood trim around the edge to stiffen it up, and the tracks are just a piece of softwood that we milled out. We put a rabbet in them to hold the letters. That. The stands we built out of 2x3s to keep them light. And the whole thing cost about $150 all in. 1/4-inch Luan, 2x3s, paint. The letters were $80 from Amazon. And that's 8-inch flexible letters. Then you can put whatever message on that you wish. Okay, take three. Something we thought worth mentioning is obviously that sign is very small and it has a lot of writing on it, and nobody will be able to understand what it says. So we believe that bigger signs with just a few words are more effective, and you have to wave when people go by. If you wave at them, they're polite and they have to look at you, and chances are they'll see your sign. So again, basic, but worth mentioning.
So when the ground's frozen, drill a hole. Put the sign in. Done.
Okay, let's move on to this project. The ladies at Kent Street came up with a great idea to draw attention to Governor Sununu's record amount of vetoes. And so what they did is bought foam core, and I brought it home and chopped it into that tombstone shape on my bandsaw so I could do, I think it was 25 at once, right in the box. And then the ladies at Kent Street, the artists, went to work and made up, I think we ended up with 79 of these. They are pretty flimsy, so we went ahead and stapled and glued a piece of Luon on the back of each one so that they could go into these stands that we made. Pretty low tech. Low tech and cheap. Yep, and so yeah, there you have it. The stands are also being used for little cutout figures of immigrants to draw our attention to the plight of immigrants at our border and in this country. And as a matter of fact, a lot of the stands are out on loan right now. So that's the Tombstone Project. Okay, this banner didn't work out, so we repurposed it. And with a little colored duct tape, you can put any message you want on there. And it's a nice big sign.